As I said, electromagnetic induction is the right. Okay. So this is a conductor. Aluminum is a conductor. So this magnet has a magnetic field around it. Okay. So when it is this, currents are produced. That is called eddy currents. Eddy currents. Have you come across eddy currents?
Yes.
So they oppose the flow of the magnet on the other side. Okay. They just oppose the flow of the magnet, so it comes slowly. Okay. And this principle is called Lenz's law. Electromagnetic induction. So now these forces, these eddy currents, prevent them, the magnet from falling. Now you can see this. Again, colors have come back to original state. So what is there between this solution
gas
and the
liquid? Gas.
Gas. So instead of gases, what are the gases? Oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide. So here, oxygen is highly reactive. So if I shake this once, there is an indicator which reacts with this solution giving red color. So this process is called partial oxidation. Okay, so come across this now, oxidation. That's why it's called color. Yeah, gaining of oxygen molecules. Then if you shake this vigorously, all the oxygen molecules react giving green. This is complete oxidation. And immediately after some time, if you release this, this oxygen molecules get back to the original position. That is called reduction. Okay. To prepare this solution, I have used water, D-glucose, sodium hydroxide pellets. To get this red and green color, I have used an indicator, indigo carbide. Okay. For this, I have used methylene. As both this process, reduction as well as oxidation takes place, this whole process is called redox reaction. Redox reaction. Okay. Letters, where are the letters gone? Disappeared. So as I said, this we have ammonium hydroxide, NH4OH base. Okay. I have written these letters with phenolphthalein. It's a colorless indicator. Okay, indicator of base. So here reaction occurs between this base and the indicator giving this reaction color. Ammonium hydroxide has gas ammonia. Okay, ammonia and water. NH4OH has nothing but NH3 and H2. So first, as soon as I sprinkle, ammonia in the form of gas escapes. So that is nothing but volatile. Volatile. Very volatile. It easily escapes in the air. So leaving behind the water molecules. So we can see the traces of this letters. After sometimes this water molecules also evaporate, so we can't see the letters. Instead of this ammonium hydroxide, if you use sodium or potassium hydroxide, the letters will be for some more time. Okay. And finally, you may all be eager to know why, who is stronger. Okay. Why 1%? Both are famous, but 1% could dare it, but others could not dare it. So, what difference can you see between these two? Many differences. Orientation. As I said, yeah, is that right? Orientation. Mode of cutting is different. So this is vertically cut, this horizontally cut. To read this paper, we will read like this. To read this, we have to turn. Since paper is obtained from wood, so in vertical section, this cellulose fibers are very weakly bonded. So we can clearly use this. Cellulose fibers. But in horizontal section, they are very strongly bonded. So if you try to tear this, it will move to the weaker side. Have applied more force. Okay. See here? How much ever if you try, it is moving on the weak. Now if you turn like this, it is easy to tear. So actually, sample you are also stronger. No, I gave this. Yeah.
Sample
A. You are also stronger, but have tricked you by giving this paper. Okay? So you are also stronger, but the paper is stronger, I guess. Okay? So with this, I end the show. Hope you all have enjoyed. Thank you for coming.